Glowing machines. I can't get the image out of my head.
We can't even.
What are you waiting around for, Outlander? Bounties are announced inside.
At least Eaterman is still alive.
Levi wasn't so chatty for his father.
We can't even keep our Sun King safe. How do we expect to win a war?
This is insane.
Starving was bad enough.
They're going to see me.
You underestimate the ease of hiding in plain sight. The balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
Every time I glance up at the floor.
Other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in, but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend into the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused. No distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride. I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels, only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure, as year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the Earth were laid bare. I suspect you'll have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identiscan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
Guess you can't have everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
Thank you.
take a seat and wait for your name to be called. A selection of beverages and snacks are available.
A smaller room.
Please proceed into viewing room 1 for an important message regarding the...
What was this place?
A holographic theater.
ZD-01 data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors that Zero Dawn is a top-secret super-weapons program, the technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague, if Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them, and they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super-weapons program, and it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating, waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you. And the work you will do here. Zero Day, the day that life on Earth ceases to exist, is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
Doesn't make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
You said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it. Kestrels. They got in. Through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Tomb?
think there is some mistake. I don't understand why I was brought here. Why would you show me these things?
I know that there's already a lot to take in.
In the waiting area, I was seated with a Nobel laureate in biophysics and a monk, I think. He spoke neither English nor Mandarin. It is very strange. And General Harris? What was he talking about? The robot swarm, the Pharaoh plague? I understand it is terrible, but it really cannot be stopped? Why tell us this? There are people in Shanghai, my friends, my family, they have joined Operation Enduring Victory already. It is for nothing? We will all die?
We're going to be able to answer some of these questions.
I just want to know why I am here. It doesn't make sense to me.
You were brought here because of your skill set.
No, that can't be right. I am an art historian. I know Dutch masters, Japanese calligraphy, Gerhard Richter. What does that matter now?
She's still here.
Calm.
Where'd you go, Chuck? Ha! Lost him! Broke bad! Where'd you go?
Too close to let tribal primitives stop us now. The data points, what did they contain?
That is accurate, yes.
So these mechanical monstrosities, they don't just kill people, they feed off them?
Not just people, all organic matter.
Every living thing dissolves into nutrients. Millennia of evolution liquefied. The miracle of life reduced to bloody biofuel.
In a word, yes.
Who did this? Pharaoh? That asshole. Is he here?
No, Doctor.
Please, tell him Tom Pike wants a word. Please! You get Ted Pharaoh in here!
Want to discuss?
Whew. So Mama, she was right.
Pardon?
My mother, she took her Bible real serious. Not just Texas Bible serious, Pentecostal serious. Favorite chapter? Revelations. Now, I didn't always understand her on account of all that speaking in tongues and such, but when she did use her words, it was always end times this and lake of fire that on account of sinful lifestyles. Speaking of which, mind if I smoke?
A tobacco cigarette.
Sorry, darling. My taste run classic. Compliments your team tracked me down. Been a price on my head 18 months now. Sterling Malky was me, don't mind admitting. And plenty of snakesters chasing the bounty, too. but I kept the zigging to their zag. How'd you finger me?
I believe Dr. Sobeck listed you as an alpha candidate. Priority snatch and grab.
Always suspected she had a little thing for me. Hey, I don't suppose you got real coffee in this place. You know, blood coffee? Conflict cappuccinos?
Mr. Tate, I'm clearing you to proceed. Just go.
With Suzanne Alpert, environmental scientist. Doctor?
I'm sorry, I wasn't,
Just stating your name. What were you thinking about, Doctor?
Nothing the General said, not really. I was on the Syzygy East Response Team in 2051, just after the second earthquake compromised the reactor. I still dream about it, after all these years. The red zone spreading on the imaging slowly, so slowly, like a hand opening its fingers.
Your involvement in that event is why you were asked for by name.
Really? That's interesting. Because nothing worked. Nothing could grow there again. It was a catastrophic failure. But the red zone is a blip compared to global scale biomass reduction. The biosphere and hydrosphere will collapse, render the Earth uninhabitable long before the robots finish us. Enduring victory can't buy time against that. So, you'd better show me what Zero Dawn really is. Previously worked for Pharaoh Automated Systems.
On the chariot line self-replication routines? I came here thinking this was a rendition. When your people took me, I thought, about time. I've been trying to swallow the guilt every day since.
Would you like to take a moment?
No. I really hoped Zero Dawn was a way to undo it all. My work, and I'm sorry to say I was ever proud of it, but Ted could really sell a concept, and in the labs, in the light of creation, that first test run, when you saw they understood their own structures, could rebuild themselves from memory and light, there were no limits. God, there were no limits.
Heavy. It's hard, too.
CD02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth Sobeck. You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super-intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the re-flourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake. Each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. How Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
Whole Earth destroyed, but then remade?
Yes, by a machine. A machine of creation.
What is it? Did this? For life, for us. But why Hades then? If it was part of Gaia, how'd it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh robot? Doesn't want to kill me. And Apollo, the Archive of Knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
Of course I'll do it. To be given the opportunity to rebuild what I, damaged? I don't feel worthy of it, but I will do it, absolutely.
I want to stress that this was never about your culpability.
It is to me. Dr. Sobek, Margot, they were smart to get out of Pharaoh when they did, but not one of us took it as a warning sign. It just told ourselves they weren't cut out for the BTRI cabals. That's the better than rapid innovation. A better at competing, better than the next guy, a better killing machine. Isn't it just amazing how a century and a half of science fiction did nothing to swerve our species from the path of doom? I mean, I'm done with that life. I mean, I will work hard, twice as hard, to earn this, for my family to have a place in Elysium. I never thought that there could be atonement.
Is he to make sure I behave this time?
Security, for your protection. Would you like to discuss how you're feeling?
Sure. I'll tell you. Surprised. No, flabbergasted. Like my own man would say, flabbergasted. That vein pumping in his forehead. I thought you people were just completely underprepared for a spaceflight project. But now I can see it's worse. Much worse. Sobek is a total fantasist, a dangerous fantasist. This kind of blue skying, it's... Jesus! I'm sorry we wasted each other's time.
I'm ready to leave now.
I'm afraid that's not possible.
Everything you're talking about here isn't possible.
I recommend you read the documents regarding your options.
I've seen enough. I'm getting out of here. What are you... You know? Get your hands off me!
If you're still nauseous.
No. The inhibitors have kicked in. I can't feel the back of my tongue. I wish I could tell you I'd believe in this. But the damage is too great, too extensive, too complete. With all respect to Dr. Sobek's work at Miriam, no. No. Life doesn't always find a way to keep going. Sometimes it never comes back. Like Syzygy East. Like the Congo. Like Timo. Like us. That's our reward? A buried city full of terminal patients waiting out the clock?
You grow old together, with your loved ones, in safety.
I don't have loved ones. I suppose I could start a family?
I'm afraid not. All inhabitants of Elysium will be medically sterilized. A habitat capable of sustaining a starting base of 2,000 individuals for up to 100 years is a huge challenge, Dr. Alpert. If the population grows instead of diminishes, everyone will be dead inside 30 years.
I knew it. I knew it. I just couldn't bring myself to say the words.
I'm sorry?
Finish it. Medical euthanasia. I want no part of this. I just want it over.
I see. Protocols require a 48-hour waiting period, after which...
This'll do.
Intruder! Get her!
Power's down.
Is there another route?
I've done this before. Just need my focus. Here we go. Another one of these. Need to find the right configuration. Done. I should check the door nearby. Found one. Looks intact. Looks like that part I found upstairs might be... That should do the trick. Now let's get that door open.
Hey! I'm done with Brett's incompetence, okay? Somehow, he managed to install an H-emitter node backwards. Everything's in reverse. I don't get paid to clean up Brett's messes. If you want it fixed, send him up to storage for a new emitter, not me. Parker out.
that did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.